Hola, video 11. Video 11, how long is this chapter? Oh, two-sided hypothesis problems involving means. Same old story, same old story. We got four steps to do. We got a state, defined parameter, and our hypotheses. We need to do the three C's, except with a two-sided. This is how you're going to know if it's two-sided again, as if in your alternate hypothesis, you use the do not equals to sign. Then the main difference compared to last video and this video is we just need to double our p-value because we are on both sides of the curve. Now, technically, one thing that's kind of wrong in this picture, we aren't going to be finding z-scores. We are going to be finding t-scores. This will be the positive t-score down here, positive whatever. This down here will be our negative version that we get. But really, in the end, all you need to do is find one area, double it, and boom, you got both. So here is our example. Let me scroll this up here. In the children's game, Don't Break the Ice, small plastic cubes are squeezed into a square frame, as seen in our lovely picture down here. Thank you, Google Images. Each child or adult, because I mean, I play this all the time personally. I just got done playing Don't Break the Ice. But I like breaking the ice, so I always lose. Each child takes turns tapping out a cube of quote unquote ice, because believe it or not, this stuff really isn't ice. It is a total lie. So don't think you're really breaking ice. I was thoroughly disappointed. With a plastic hammer, hoping that the remaining cubes don't collapse. So in ways, it's kind of like Jenga in a way, but two-dimensional and with fake ice. Yeah, thanks, Milton Bradley. For the game to work correctly, the cubes must be big enough so that they hold each other in place in the plastic frame, but not so big that they are too difficult to tap out. The machine that produces the plastic cubes is designed to make cubes that are exactly 29.5 millimeters wide, but the actual width varies a little. To ensure that the machine is working well, a supervisor inspects a random sample of 50 cubes every hour and measures their width. Use the information from the printout to test this claim. Also, verify your conclusion with the 95% confidence interval. So here is our computer printout. Now here's our hypotheses right here. Mu is equal to 29.5 versus it is not equal to 29.5 because some of our cubes may be smaller or larger than what they should be. Here's our sample size of 50. Here is the sample mean that we got. Here is our sample standard deviation. Here is the standard error of the mean, which I will show you something which is kind of important with this number later. And here's our confidence interval. So our hypotheses, 29.5 or it's not 29.5, where mu is our mean width in millimeters of a block of quote unquote ice. Thank you, Milton and Bradley. Jerks. Conditions. It did specifically say random sample of 50 cubes, so that checks. Can we assume that there are more than 500 cubes produced? Probably so. I think this is a fairly popular game with kids, so I think we can assume that there are more than 500 made. And is our sample size, or do we have a normal distribution? And again, remember, we're not really talking about normal when we are talking about means. We're really wanting to talk about t. Now, I don't have any data, so I can't make a box plot out of. But I don't need to make a box plot because my sample size is 50, which is sufficiently large enough for the central limit theorem to guarantee that we are definitely dealing with a t distribution or that t procedures are okay to use. We may use TCDF in our calculator. Calculations now. Now, basically, all the information I need is in this information up here. So here is my basic formula that I'm going to use. My x bar, that's my sample mean. Well, that's this number, this 29.4874. And the mu value comes from my hypothesized mean of 29.5, which is, hey, right here. So here are the two numbers I'm subtracting from there. Now, s is my sample standard deviation, which is this value, 0.09347. And n, hey, there's n right there. They just happen to put a capital N, should really be lowercase, of 50. And that's that number. Now, one thing I want to point out here is this standard error of the mean. Really, all this right here, this is the standard error. Okay. This standard deviation of the statistic is an AKA, which is also known as, for those that maybe did not know that, this is the standard error of the mean. So what is 0.09347 divided by the square root of 50? It's this number right here. So we didn't even really have to put this. You could just pop a squat. They're 0.01322 right here in the denominator, because that's what number you're going to get, fool. Now, we figure out what this is, and we get 0.9531. Is that number anywhere up here? No, we don't need it quite yet. But now, if I take a look at a pic, here's my t-score. Here's really the one I found, which I would shade as, more extreme than would be in this tail. But since this is a two-sided test, not equal to, then I also need to symmetrically go over here to my right side and the positive version of my t-score and shade more extreme than it, so in this tail. So when I want to find my p-value, because this has taken up quite a bit of space, so I'm thinking maybe my p-value is going to be pretty big. I think it's probably not going to be less than 5%, but let's see. So the probability that I get a t-score that's more extreme as my negative 0.9531 will be my t-CDF. So really, I am focusing on, when I say this, I'm going to be finding the area of this tail. So my lower bound is negative infinity. My upper bound is that negative 0.9531. And I also have to put in degrees of freedom, which is one less than my sample size of 49. So if I punch out my calculator, I should get a decently sized p-value. And keep in mind, this is only a half p-value. This is 17.26%. So I double that for two tails. And again, sometimes I will write tails after this too to kind of remind myself, why am I doubling this number? And so we get a p-value that's 34.5%. So what decision are we going to make at 34.5%? Here's our next part. Since the p-value is not less than our alpha value of 0.05, we conclude we do not have enough evidence at the 0.05 level or the 5% level to conclude the mean width for ice cubes is not equal to our 29.5 millimeters. Okay, so basically with this information, we are saying we would fail to reject the null hypothesis. Now, I also wanted you to look at the confidence interval. So here is the confidence interval already calculated for you. Now, what we're asking is, here's our null hypothesis. Is the null hypothesis inside this confidence interval? And 29.5 is inside here. So we don't want to reject this value, which is our null hypothesis. So we would also, down here, we would fail to reject the null hypothesis because 29.5 is inside this confidence interval. Okay, so I said here, since 29.5 is in our 95% confidence interval, we do have reason to believe that the true mean width, mu, is in fact 29.5. It is possible that that really is the legitimate mean width for all the ice cubes being produced. Now, if 29.5 was not in our confidence interval, then we would want to go with the alternate hypothesis, which says it is not equal to 29.5. So we would reject the null hypothesis in that case and go with the alternate. But again, that was only if 29.5 was not in our confidence interval, but it is. So we fail to reject. Now, here is the example that's in the book that's already worked out. You can pause the video intermittently and kind of read through and look through all this. Here's something we haven't really done in a little while, checking for outliers using the 1.5 IQR rule all the way back from, I don't know, chapter one, two, something like that. And then here's actually doing the four-step process. So you can kind of read through this. Here's our calculating stage. Here's our concluding stage. You can read through that. And then here's more answers still. Kind of scroll this down so you can read what's all in there. Do, 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 do. And then here is the one question I want you to do. And it does extend onto the next page. So you will want to pause the video and examine this. And then here is the second question down here. And answer that. So with that, I bid you adieu, and we will proceed on. Adios.